Incoming above you!
Until they are at rest.
What is wrong?
I died. And you will help me.
Of course, Gunhild. But to what end?
When the Einherjar came, we needed a way to fight them. I suggested saving them.
I understand your desperation, but that was foolish.
Clearly. I was lucky enough to be murdered before my mind could be corrupted, as theirs did. You must free them.
Of course. Say their magic corrupts so ruthlessly. Those poor souls must be in agony.
Then we shall give them death.
How do we get up there, I wonder?
We can't. Not with those vines in the way. Doesn't look like we can reach it from down here.
My friend's souls are still twisted, aren't they? Give them the freedom of death.
Waterfalls. We're close. There should be a gate up ahead.
That's quite a gate. Don't suppose you know a way through.
A pilgrim gate. I can open it. We just need to find the right vantage point.
Freya, there's something I've always wanted to ask. What was it Hrimthor whispered to you?
Who?
Hrimthor, the son of Thormur, the stonemason, who disguised himself and built Asgard's wall.
Oh, yes. One of the many occasions Odin saw fit to involve me in a wager without my consent. I wish I could say that was the worst of his husbandly habits.
What wager?
I've told this story, brother.
And now she may tell her own.
There isn't that much to tell. I knew nothing of it at first, surely because Odin didn't expect to lose the bet. A mysterious mason had to build the entire wall in 3 turns of the season.
2! It was 2!
And if he was late, he'd be owed nothing. But if he succeeded, he was promised an audience with the queen. Or so I learned one day when Odin burst into our bedchambers, raging and half-drunk before noon, telling me to get dressed and go see what the mason wants. So, off I went, not knowing what had truly been promised or expected. Dagger stashed in my robe for emergency. And this mason, this giant in disguise...
His name was Hrimthur!
He just smiled to see me. And as you said, he whispered in my ear. He said the Aesir had killed his father, and he needed to know that one day they'd burn for it. I pointed out I was Aesir now too, technically. He gave me a look, as if he somehow knew better, and continued. He said he'd built in a structural flaw behind the Asgard Realm Tower.
I knew it! How do we make use of it?
We don't. He said Surtur would know what to do. And if Surtur's approaching Asgard's wall...
Then it is already Ragnarok.
Aye. Blast it. I hoped it might have given us another way.
Despite his actions in Midgard, Atreus does still care for you.
I know. I raised a son, too. It may be hard to believe, but he was quite similar to Atreus at this age. He adored his father, always wanted to do right by him, and was constantly frustrated that no matter what he did, he never could seem to get his approval. He confided in me a lot, sought the comfort his father withheld. I wonder if your son could benefit from that, too.
He has befriended the other dwarf. The Blue One's brother.
Oh. Well, if Sindri has that covered, I suppose there's no need for me in his life anymore, is there?
That is not what I meant.
That was sarcasm.
What is it, Mimir?
That's nothing, brother. Just... You ever have those moments where you wish you could... go back? Rewrite your own past.
Please.
Make different decisions.
Journeying through time is more trouble than it is worth.
Ah, fair point. You're speaking metaphorically, right?
No.
Of course you're not. Like more of Lunda's old armor. Nearly have the complete set now.
Must be safer this way. We'll need to find another way around.
Thank you.
Mimir, I never asked how it felt to lose your head.
What would you have me say? That it tickled?
Merely curious.
If you wish to derive some satisfaction from my pain, I'm afraid you'll be disappointed. Kratos swung swift and true, didn't you, brother? I felt nary a scratch.
Shame.
long as they still haunt this realm, so will I.
So, what's it like, being back?
Like I haven't come back at all. Everything's changed. I'm a stranger here.
I know the feeling.
The runic word appeared over there. See it? Mekking. We should be able to reach the wedding site.
My friends' souls are still twisted, aren't they? Give them the freedom of death.
And whatnot. A good fit.
Keep your bits in all the right places. Family crests? I'll take them. Somebody ought to save these, even if the VANAHEIM won't. Take your crap. Hmm. Feels like there was something else. That'll mess some folks up. Lady Freya? Need something special?
And how is it you two know each other?
Nah, I can't be divulging guild business. You gotta respect the secretude of it all.
I'm sorry?
Let's just say Brock and I have long enjoyed certain common interests.
That's right. Like getting us into trouble.
And getting you back out of it again.
What? Huh. That's only mostly.
Okay, so does that answer your question?
Close enough, I suppose. The closer we get, the more tightness grows in my chest.
You're sure you want to continue?
Confronting the past comes with a price.
It must be done. I've lived with this pain far too long. If you can believe it. We were happy once. For a time, foolishly believed the peace would last. Perhaps that was my mistake. All I wanted was to protect my family.
There is no shame in that.
I failed all the same. Those scrawlings must be Sather nearby.
Lunda's orb.
Be cautious. We know not what it does.
You really think she'd send us to get the bloody thing if it was going to kill us? Let's just take it back to her.
You know, I would have beaten you.
What?
Earlier, if Atreus hadn't been there.
Perhaps.
We could go again, find out for certain.
I would rather not.
I'll bet you wouldn't.
Do you know why I left that night, Mimir?
Only a hunch.
He showed me who he really was. Odin asked me to cast a protection spell on him. The one I used on my son. But the way it drove our boy mad, I refused. He was furious, throwing every object he could find, destroyed the room. There was only coldness after that. I tried to make it work.
No one could have lived like that, Your Majesty.
You're free, little one.